Welcome to a look in the future. What would you do if you can go in the future and ask yourself questions? How do you grow your firm? How do you transition to advisory services? How do you add more value to your clients? Luckily, we can just ask the time traveler himself, Paul Latham, and learn the knowledge we need at our firms to evolve into advisory services and become the most relevant advisor to our clients. Paul brings three amazing things with him. Number one, he's built a successful accounting practice in the UK, so he understands accountants. In fact, he built his firm into an advisory powerhouse, which sold for $45 million in 2001. Number two, he's taken a business public, building it to a market value in excess of $400 million. So he really understands what business owners need and value, and what we as accountants need to provide to them. And finally, as I said, third, we don't need to invent time travel or the flux capacitor. We can just ask Paul and learn from the transition he made 20 years ago in the UK into providing business advisory services, as that trend is here today in the United States. I'm Garrett Wagner, your entrepreneurial CPA channel host, and I'm really excited today to be joined by the legendary Paul Latham of Hayden Rock Solutions. Because on this episode, we're going to continue to take a little bit of a deeper dive, talking about, you know, expanding on what we talked about before. Why do firms struggle to sell and deliver advisory services? Those were our past two episodes. And Paul, something you mentioned in those episodes was you talked a lot about boxes of products. And we've got a lot of questions on that. So Paul, let's take a little bit deeper dive into that. What are these boxes of products that you keep referring to?
Hi, Gareth, how are you doing? Really good question. I say a really good question. It's probably because it's one of my favorite subjects. Creating boxes of products. I'm going to try and go into a bit of detail. Another way of me thinking about it, and I'll come back to this analogy as I go through the boxes of products, is to think about your box of products a little bit like a Coca-Cola shaped bottle. It's an analogy I've used a few times. And sort of where we really have to go back to with this is, if I'm talking to you about creating a Coca-Cola shaped brand proposition, you can obviously immediately imagine in your head what a Coca-Cola bottle shape looks like. And so you've got that brand really in your head. Now let's look at most CPAs. Most CPAs have a big, big problem creating a solid brand. So again, just to draw the analogy, if you're in a business that manufactures a product, e.g. a Coca-Cola bottle, it's really easy for you or any of the customers to visualize that brand image. But it's not so easy. If I say to you, now imagine a CPA service, that's actually quite hard for you to visualize because it's intangible. And of course, it's not as defined as a Coca-Cola bottle or some sort of manufactured product. It's an intangible service. And what CPAs really need to understand in terms of this creating boxes of product is that they need to make their service solid, like a box or a Coca-Cola bottle, and repeatable and consistent. So think of it like a production line of Coca-Cola shaped bottles coming off that production line, and your advisory services are similarly easy to recognize, solid, repeatable, and consistent. And basically, if a CPA or indeed any other service business is going to do this, then what it needs to think about is what I call a rational and logical approach to strengthen their brand that also serves to deepen the customer relationship. But if the CPA or indeed any other service business, if they've got clients who are service businesses, the same problem applies to their clients. But what they need to do is to really align three things. They need to create that box of product that's consistent. They need to align, number one, their business purpose. Number two, their value promise. And really, it's the purpose and the value promise, which are all about how you sell the box of product. And then the third thing is the customer service delivery process that you create, which is how you deliver the box of product or the Coca-Cola shaped bottle. And to be honest, Garrett, you asked this question, and there are really two parts to the answer. There's how you sell or how you create the product that you're going to sell, and how you then define the product that you're going to deliver. And because we normally talk for maybe 6, 7, 8 minutes, I actually think it's pushing it to deal with both of those in the same episode. So if you don't mind, maybe what we'll do in this one is concentrate on create the sell product, and then maybe next time we'll talk about the delivery. Is that okay with you, Gareth?
Yeah, it sounds like an excellent plan, because really we're kind of taking everything we've talked about so far in all these episodes and really kind of bringing it together. We're going on a conceptual vision, and we're solidifying this and talking specifically advisory services. We all want to do it. Let's take the mystery out of it, define it. Here's our box, here's our bottle. And yeah, that hardest part that we face as CPAs is how do we sell it?
Yeah, exactly. And it sort of even comes before selling it, which is getting you and your team in a place where they understand what we're trying to do. So number one, if we're looking at today on the sell side, I actually think even before the sell, it's really, really, really understanding your business purpose. So we've got a business purpose. What message is going to resonate ultimately with the clients as part of the sell, but also with the team? Because we want the team to deliver this box of product. We want the team to deliver this Coca-Cola shaped bottle. So we need the team, our business purpose, to resonate with them. It drives them. It links to the business values and the culture. And what we need to do is, yeah, we're going to be delivering this Coca-Cola shaped bottle. It's a job worth doing. And let's make it exciting. And this is the part, I mean, again, you're talking about pulling all things together. You know, most CPAs don't make their business feel exciting, certainly not to their team. They don't make it feel like a job worth doing. You know, we're going to do tax returns for the next 6 weeks. Get on with it. Now let's make it feel like a job worth doing. And I always tend to draw the analogy, or there's a story, I should say, rather than an analogy, of the guy who worked at NASA, the cleaner, and the president of the US was visiting, and he happened to ask the guy what he did for a job. And the answer was, he didn't say, "I'm a cleaner." He said, "I'm part of a team that has a mission to put a man on the moon." And so that purpose resonated with that cleaner, and it drove him to carry on working. And obviously, most businesses haven't got a mission that's quite as exciting as putting a man on the moon. But often what I talk about is creating a Navy SEAL culture, a culture where that team are all working together, got each other's backs, pulling for each other. And that sort of bedrock of purpose and understanding why we're doing this business advisory service, I think, sort of is necessary when it comes to the selling and delivering. But once you've got that purpose in place, then you can move into, okay, so our purpose, you know, is to add value to businesses, be more forward looking, help them to grow, and so on. What's our value promise, and why do our clients choose us, and what do they value? And when I talk about what do they value, I'm differentiating what they value from what they expect. And really thinking about what the client values. I'm, as you know, Gareth, I'm full of analogies, but I often talk about, why do people buy a drill? If you're selling a drill, why do people buy a drill? And most people who sell drills seem to focus on the performance of the drill. You know, it does 10,000 revolutions a minute or some technical feature of it. You know, it's basically a very fast whiz-bang drill. And they try and sell it on that premise. And truthfully, most customers couldn't give a damn about the technical capabilities of a drill. They just want a hole in the wall. And rather than sell the hole in the wall, which is what the customer values, they try and sell the stuff, the technical stuff. And so I see accountants, CPAs, you know, they focus on things like saying, well, you know, we're experienced, we're professional, we're timely, we're responsive. Well, you know, that's sort of like selling the technical aspect of a drill. No one cares. It's your minimum expectation anyway of a CPA. You know, would you go to a CPA that wasn't experienced or professional or timely or responsive? Of course you wouldn't. So it's a minimum expectation. You know, if you're not experienced or professional or timely or responsive, then you have a problem, but it's not the reason why people come to you. And it just makes you all sound the same. So in the beginning, what you've really got to do is create a box of product that looks different to the customer. And obviously this will vary from CPA to CPA, but let me just use the Latham's example. So when I was at Latham's, you know, on the whole, we had business owners of a certain size coming to us, you know, 5-10 million of revenue. And what they wanted to do was grow their business. And our box of product that we created was all about, in the first place, clarifying their direction, building a business that looked like one that somebody maybe would want to buy. But ultimately, what we're going to do with you is clarify your direction, but then help you to maximize your business potential. What you're going to get is we're going to help you to grow your business, grow your revenues, grow your profit, grow your value. So the box of products, or the Coca-Cola shaped bottle, if you like, is shaped around business direction and maximizing your business potential. It's got nothing to do with accounts and things or tax returns. Those are just minimum expectations. That's why you come into us. Here's this box of product, and it's going to help you, for instance, clarify direction, maximize potential. Would you like that box of product that's going to do that? And then we can begin to break that down into little sub elements of the product. And so that first part of the sell is getting the purpose right and sort of making sure that the box of product looks different to your competition, but that you can define it. And once you've defined it, and well, as I say, I'd probably prefer to talk then in more detail, because we do get quite detailed in the second episode about then number three. So, okay, we've defined the product. Now, how do we deliver it so it's consistent and a driven process, and it contains the valuable stuff that the client wants? Does that make sense, Gareth?
Yeah, and really, you know, you're taking all these things and you're taking kind of the Hanrock process and the biz process we've talked about, and you're really applying it first to the CPA firm. You know, kind of we say the biz process, vision, plan, desire. Mm-hmm. A lot of what you said there rang in my head is the vision phase.
Yes. Clarify direction, you see. So exactly what you're beginning to do, and you're picking up on it there, is if we're going to clarify, you know, what we're going to do for you. Big picture, we're going to clarify your direction. You know where you're going to go, and then we're going to help you maximize your potential. That sounds interesting to the client. It's something, I'd like to know that. And we'll talk more about this getting into detail. But that clearly the clarified direction takes you to a vision product. The maximized business potential will take you to a plan product or an accountability desire product. And so this begins to fit into your box of products. And remember I said before about being aligned, so that what you sell and what you deliver is aligned. And it's, you know, mentally creating this box of product. And the Coca-Cola analogy, I'm going to draw out more when we get to the delivery, but it's shaping what we do. This is what we say, this is what we do. This is what we say, this is what we do. And if you ever sort of move away from the alignment of this is what we say, this is what we do, when it comes to an intangible service like advisory, you're in big trouble.
And that's where, too, it sounds like this starts inside with the CPA firm. You know, kind of talking about providing direction to your clients, where they want to go. It starts with the firm. If you don't have that direction, you're not going to be able to sell this.
Exactly. So, but it's also explaining to the team why we're doing it, you know.
Yeah.
If the team don't understand that this is what we're doing, then they won't, when it comes round to delivering it, they won't sort of feel like they understand it or why they're doing this or why it matters or why their job is important.
Yeah.
So it starts with I always say it's sort of, you know, the sort of three or four big elements of running a business. It's the why, which is the purpose. It's the what, which is the value that we sell. And then it's the how do we deliver it? The why, the what, and the how have to be aligned. Start with, you know, this is why we're doing it. We need to be a forward-looking accountant. This is what we're going to say to our clients. This is the box that we're going to sell. Now what goes inside the box? Let's align it and create that sort of image of a Coca-Cola shaped bottle. That's what the client's going to get. And we'll talk, what I'd prefer to do is go into a bit more detail then on how we then shape the Coca-Cola bottle in the next episode.
No, and I'm excited. So everyone stay tuned for part two, really, as we dive into that bottle and how do you deliver this. So stay tuned. We'll be back with more real soon. Before we wrap up, you know, when me and Paul talk about this and the conversation we're having right now, we're always surprised at how many CPA firms are really not ready for the future. They don't realize it. They're not ready to deliver advisory services. And we think you need to know where you stand today. How ready is your firm for the future? Talked about the biz score. vision, plan, desire. What's your biz score? What does your vision, plan, and desire look like? We want you to know. Let's take a minute. Sign up for our free biz survey. There's a link below. It's a special offer. We'll provide you the results and have a quick meeting with you afterwards. Provide those results, get on the same page, see how ready you are for the future, because that's what it's all about. Like I said, we'll be back with part two, so stay tuned. As always, you can click up here to subscribe to the YouTube channel, and we encourage you, take steps today to invest in yourself and to change the world.